For those of you who don't know, okay, now you do. I never wanted to know because I thought as long as I believed that I would get by, I would go on. That was what gave me my strength and my determination. And I lost somebody who meant a lot to me, and I quit. On March 12th, I quit. A week before my birthday. So for all those of you who have talked about me and said things about me and have like questioned and wondered, yes, I have a problem. And it's not just one. I've got several. The problem is that all I ever wanted to do was to do a good job to make somebody else happy. That's why I did drag, because it was the only thing I knew that I could do that I thought was of any value. I came from a functional family, and I failed. But the only legacy that I have is that I have the best friends on earth. I have Mr. Charles Armstrong, who was there for me even though we had our differences on too many occasions. But Charles said, you have the ball, you run with it. If you fuck up, I hold you responsible. I used to think the same way, but then I started to think there's that consideration. Everybody from time to time makes a mistake. Well, Charles taught me something very valuable. I think that Alan Delman, who's been there for me through thick and through thin and never questioned. Yeah, but he spread some shit about me. But it wouldn't be Alan. I am humbled because this show of affection and attention is at the same time, I'm so full of pride. So, like, how can I have one of the deadly virtues and one of the greatest things on earth? Be humble and proud at the same time. I am humbled because I cannot believe and fathom for the life of me that so many people sincerely care about me. It hurts. No, please. I do not wish to be dramatic, therefore I wrote these things down. You don't understand, but I have had some wonderful experiences and some great moments. But tonight is the greatest moment of my life, because you are here because you want to be and you sincerely care. I love you just as much as you love me, and I hope that I didn't ever forget to say thank you, and if I did, I do now. I also have to tell you that I wanted so very much to see me and to be happy and to perform, and I never thought that I was any different from anyone else. Just dedicated and committed to this art form because I wasn't here to make it. I wasn't here to make it. I was wait, please, just let me finish and I'll leave you alone. I swear to God. I swear to God, I'll never, ever bore the shit out of you again. I swear tonight on... And I swore I wasn't gonna curse, Mary. You made me curse. Okay, I'm gonna read the script after that. I was surrounded by the best, is why I look so good. If there was anything that I knew what was good. I knew what was talented. I was taught that because my parents raised me to be better than because I was a second-class citizen, a Negro, and I had the most comfort. And I had, because for all those of you who know me, you never ever thought of me as a black. Not that I'm not proud of those things, but I am terribly proud of those things. The problem is that I feel that we can look at each other as we are, that person. You guys did that to me. I never suffered any kind of racism or bigotry because you got to know me and accepted me. I appreciate that. That is the most important thing. But personally, only if you can come to me, I know you heard this before. But I wanted to be a person and now I'm going to thank Tiffany Jones because she was my inspiration. Differed on occasion, but we both had the same ideal. I wanted to be as popular and as loved as Chocolate Larry, my friend, for 17 years. I wanted wanted to be as dynamic as Donna Day. I wanted to be creative and as ingenious as Tasha Cole. I wanted to be all those things, but time and time again, the coach said that I fell into a little bit, that I was a commercial service, and all I was me. And what I had to do was a killer. And that was the greatest thing on earth that ever happened to me, because I was the glue for that group. And I had the best company around me. And that's why I look good. I fooled you all. The greater part of that time, I was blessed with the best emotions with incredible friends. Friends that on times when I called them and I said, "Hi, how are you?" Like David Bennett said, "I'm again. What do you need?" I'll fight to the end. I think I want to break it down. I'm not so sure. But the problem is that the knife gave me the strength and the desire to fight. Go on and to be better. I thank the knife. I ask you please just to be a little patient with me. That's all I ask. Somebody who has the most incredible mind. I've been so happy. You have no idea how blessed I feel. I have been given the world on a platter and I fucked it up. But now I'm gonna make it right. I'm gonna show you all. The last thing on earth that I ever want to see is any of you folks like I've told when I lost the money. So I tell you what, stubborn and strong-willed and strong-headed, and you know that, don't you? Yes. So, I'm ready for the joy and the happiness to give you your best. I'm not going nowhere. I refuse. I am here, and Alan, Charles, Larry, Donna, Tasha, and each and every one of you, I have a reason now. Because I don't want to see any one of you hurt because of me. Because all I want to do is make you happy. Well, I'm going to keep on making you happy. Okay? I have a reason. Michael, I have a reason, Alan. Because I owe you all so much. Please. Thank you.
Naomi Sims, ladies and gentlemen. Naomi's going to take her place of honor at the table. Naomi has asked me to ask some of you that are standing up, if you don't mind, if you'd like to come sit on the floor like we usually do here at Heaven, you're certainly more than welcome to. Come move right on down to the dance floor. I'd also like to tell you, by special arrangement with Mr. Charles Armstrong and the cast, 100% of tonight's door proceeds and tips go directly to Naomi Sims. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present Miss Gay Houston Coffee.